everybody, welcome to the vlog. It is Monday. It's kind of a weird Monday. We're the only ones in the office today, other than our pastor. He's been like in and out with meetings, so we've been the only ones. So it's like weird because we're used to everybody being around, so it's like kind of lonely in the office today. But we're gonna get some work done. It's like 500 degrees in this car right now. I can hardly even breathe. But anyways, Manny, did you know that there was tornadoes in Dallas, like, yesterday? There was apparently tornadoes in Dallas yesterday. Somebody told me that, and we literally only live a couple hours from Dallas, and I knew there was some bad storms. I didn't know it was tornadoes. Anyway, so we're going home for lunch. Haven't vlogged in a couple of days. Being honest, it's been a really rough week, so I will talk about that eventually. I think I'm going to have a video coming out kind of going more in detail on that because I just don't want it to be this one. I don't really want to discuss that situation right now. But it's been a rough week and I've been not feeling myself, kind of down, but it's going to be okay. We're good. Everybody's fine. And yeah, yesterday was obviously Sunday. And so we had service. And then just kind of came home and rested. So right now we're gonna go home for lunch. I really need to clean up the house. I've been kind of slacking on everything just because honestly it's been like a really rough week and I just have not cared about cleaning up the house, I'm gonna be honest. So I need to do that. And I need to also eat something. I think I'm gonna have some shrimp and make some coffee. I haven't had coffee yet and my glasses are fogging up. That's why I don't like to wear them when it's really hot out. Yesterday on stage I had to wear my glasses. I'm out of contacts. And I was sweating really bad on stage. And they were so fogged at one point. Like, I was about to just throw them down. And then also, I busted my lip on the microphone, which happens a lot. But it started bleeding, which that's happened before. But it, like, wasn't, like, pouring blood, thankfully. But there was definitely blood coming off whenever I would touch it. So, that was great. This tree is, like, straight up falling apart. There's this huge, like, branch over here. Like, huge branch that just fell off the tree, so. Okay, so I wanted to show you guys really quickly. Okay, so I got this shrimp, or we got this shrimp sauce from Great Value from Walmart. And it's called the Boom Boom Shrimp Sauce. I've been telling you guys about all these different sauces from Walmart that are so good. And we just had this for lunch, and it is amazing. Apparently, you're supposed to, like, mix the shrimp up in it so it's like fully covering the shrimp. I didn't do that. I just dipped it in there because I didn't know, because I guess that's what Boom Boom Shrimp actually is. But anyway, it's really good. And this is the shrimp, also from Great Value, breaded butterfly shrimp. It's really good too. Okay, so I just went into the dollar store, Dollar General actually, and got these lashes because I've been seeing people talk about the Dollar General brand, this Believe Beauty or whatever it's called. Yeah, Believe Beauty. And these lashes look really pretty, so I'm excited to try them. Okay, so we're home, and I want to show you guys these lashes a little bit. They're from Believe Beauty, like I said. It's one pair of lashes and lash glue. I have my own lash glue, but I'm going to use this just to put, I'll probably just like put one of them on to show you what they look like. Not going to wear them, and I'm just going to probably just pop one of them on or something to show you what they look like. My face looks rough, so we're going to ignore that. But I am going to have to take my glasses off, obviously. I don't have any contacts right now, so hopefully I can see. But I'm going to pop one of these on. Okay, so I don't really have like a place to set any of this up, so I'm just going to show you. They're really pretty. They're really wispy. Looks like this particular pair. I got the Goddess pair. They have like different, I'm like squatting down because I don't have a setup for this. I wish I did, but I got the Goddess pair. They have like the Glamour pair or something. They had like several pairs, but so they're really pretty. I'm gonna use the glue that they provided. I normally use black glue. Actually, I like this glue. It's kind of like a little, maybe all of this kind of glue looks like this, but it looks different than I'm used to. I use one from Kiss. This glue is like super clear. I can't even tell if it's coming out. I'm gonna apply it real quick. So this is with
Not a lot of makeup, a lot of sweat, but I really, really like these.
I may trim the inside of them. I don't usually trim my lashes, but I might trim these. I know most people always trim a little bit. I love them though. They're really pretty with like a full eye look. These are gonna be so pretty, and they're like exactly the kind of lash that I like the more wispy lash. I either like the wispy like this, or like the ones that like are almost like in bunches. I forget what those are called, but I have some like that, and I love those as well. I've been trying magnetic lashes as well, and I do like them. I've been wearing them pretty often. I do have an easier time with the glue on lashes, probably because I've used them the most. Magnetic lashes are harder for me to apply, but I did end up finding like there are a couple different ones that I can use that are easier, but they're not easier than glue for me, so I wouldn't use them because they're easier. But if you're wearing lashes every day, it is nice when you don't have to like rip the lashes off at night. The glue that I use from Kiss is like really good glue, like really hardcore, so which is a good thing. But you know, for a normal day, sometimes I do like to change it up and wear magnetic, but glue-ons are still my favorite kind of lash. But anyway, I just want to show you that. I'm gonna show you really quickly the lash glue that I like. My favorite lash glue. I need to organize these drawers. But this is my favorite lash glue that I've ever tried. It's the Kiss Strip Lash Adhesive with aloe. This dries black. They have other ones, I think, but this is the black one. This is my favorite. I've had a couple of these, maybe more, and I love this. I've used this for a while, and I love this glue. It's like the best one that I've tried. Since we're doing a little show and tell, these Oreo Thins, the latte Oreo Thins, I got these at Walmart. They are so good. I absolutely love these. Also, speaking of Walmart, quick story, and then I will wrap up today's video, but quick story. So I went to Walmart on Friday, and we got like just a few little grocery items, and I got the Panera macaroni and cheese, the one in the little containers, like already made up. They had like the soups and everything, and I got the macaroni and cheese. Get it all the time. Love it. I've never had a problem with getting their macaroni and cheese. I didn't eat it Friday. Didn't eat it Saturday, but I thought about it all weekend. I love that stuff. I love their soup. I love their macaroni. So anyway, on Sunday, I literally thought about it during church, that when I came home, I was going to eat that macaroni. So I came home. I was seriously so excited, you guys, about this macaroni and cheese. And I got it out. I opened it up because you're supposed to take, you know, the seal and everything off of it to microwave it. And so I opened it up, and there was mold. And I will show you a picture, but there was mold on this macaroni. And I was so frustrated about it because I really wanted, which is like not really a big deal, but at the same time, it is kind of a big deal because mold is like a big deal. It's like not a healthy thing at all to have on macaroni and cheese, something that kids eat, something that you eat, you know, whatever. So it is kind of a big deal at the same time because obviously there shouldn't be mold on food. So I checked the date. I know Walmart occasionally, you know, probably sells things that are older, and I think people have had issues with that occasionally before, or at least almost outdated, but it was not anywhere. I mean, it was expired in July, which this is June, but it should not be moldy a month before the expiration date. That's really weird. And so I put it on. No, I never do this. I don't like to complain about things like that, like to a company or whatever, unless it's something big. And I felt like that was a big thing. Like if all of them are contaminated, I don't want people to deal with that and, you know, whatever. So I took the macaroni and cheese back, first of all, and got my money back for it. And then I put it on Twitter and my Instagram story, that a picture of it, and saying like that it was moldy. I tagged Panera in it. So they responded to me and said, first, like, it was just confusing. At first they said that they would basically have me talk to, or have me email or direct message them more information. And then when I did that, somebody got in touch with me through email that was all kinds of confused, and they said that basically I shouldn't eat things that are expired, which doesn't make any sense because obviously anybody knows that, and it wasn't expired. So I responded. They said they would give me a coupon. It was a coupon that you can find online for $1.50 off. This stuff is like $5 a thing, so it's not cheap. I don't even like to buy it because of that, but I like it so much that I spend the money on it. So anyways, They gave me like $1.50 off. I was like, that's ridiculous because it's moldy food. Like, I need more than that. So I responded and said, you know, that's great, but it wasn't expired. And it was nowhere near expired. And, like, it was moldy. And honestly, the coupon's nice, but like, I'm not going to use that because I don't know if the rest of it's moldy. I don't know what the problem is here. So I'm not going to use the moldy, you know, I'm not going to use a coupon to get moldy food. So anyways, then they responded and said, sorry for the confusion. They didn't know that it wasn't expired and all this stuff, and then they said that they're gonna be sending me like a thing for a free one, which I mean, I can't expect anything more than that, really, but I just, hopefully they're not all contaminated. They asked what Walmart it was found at and like the number on it, so I'm assuming Panera's a good company. I have nothing like negative to say about Panera. I love Panera, I like going to Panera, they have great food. So I think that if there is a problem, they will definitely recall it or something. I know that one of their soups is actually recalled right now, the one in the container, it was a voluntary recall. So if there is a problem, I know they'll take care of it, but it still kind of grosses me out to even think about that. So it's going to take me a little bit. I'll be able to eat it again, but it's going to take me a minute to get over that so that I can eat their macaroni again. But anyways, I'm going to go ahead and end today's vlog. Just a short little vlog, show my lashes, talking about the story because I didn't vlog yesterday when it happened. So I wanted to show you, and I have pictures because I sent them pictures. So anyways, I will talk to you guys later. Remember, you are incredible. Jesus loves you. Sorry, my voice sounds kind of weird today. I feel like it sounds really strange, and I think I'm getting either some allergies or a little cold or something. So I sound really weird. But anyways, remember, you are incredible. Jesus loves you, and I'll see you later. Bye, guys.